Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome into SEC TV Sports for tonight's boys hockey matchup between the Chisago Lakes Wildcats and the Tartan Titans. I am your commentator, Earnhardt Michael Jaworski. And on this chilly Thursday evening, two teams go head-to-head in a non-conference matchup, but it will... How do I put this? It'll be very, very close between these two teams. It's the third meeting of all time between Tartan and Chisago Lakes. Chisago Lakes not too far up the road here from Tartan. But for the Titans and the Wildcats, at this point in the season, you start to ramp things up come section playoffs, and you want to go into the postseason with as much momentum as you possibly can. And looking at the tail of the tape here, Tartan, here at home, they're 0-5, looking to get their first win on the board, but they are undefeated against Chisago. So that is a huge plus for Tartan, as for the Wildcats, are averaging almost 4 goals a game, and they're 5-4 on the road. They've won 4 out of their last 5 as well. So for the Wildcats, they're in a bit of a hot streak here as of late. But here at Tartan Arena, the Titans have always been strong at home in previous years. The Titans look to get back on the right foot here in late January, back on home ice. We'll take a look at conference standings for both schools here in the Metro East. Tartan, they're near the bottom, 1-6, 2-15 on the year. The Metro East so stacked this year. You have your perennials, Hillbury, Matavita, and St. Thomas Academy. Two Rivers looking very strong this year as well. Hastings is solid as well. So for Tartan, it's been a tough bout here this season. And for Chisago Lakes in the Mississippi 8, they're a few points off of the Monticello Moose. 6 points back. Chisago 7-6. They're just floating over 500 barely, but they've played a pretty tough schedule as well. Got Cambridge Asante in there as well. Chisago Lakes was able to take down Cambridge Asante 4-0 earlier in the season. And I believe we're going to take a look at starting goalies here tonight. The two netminders in net. It's going to be Ben Bengura, the junior for Tartan. He's got an .869 save percentage, 4.8 goals against average. And for Chisago Lakes, for the Wildcats in net, they're gonna have Jack Hansen, the senior. He's 5-6-1 on the year. He had 3.3 goals against average and an .897 save percentage for the Wildcats. They're gonna be leaning heavily on their goaltender in Hansen. As starting lineups about to get underway here. But before we get to that, players to watch, we got to look out for Noah Joyce here. Joyce, he's got 24 points on the year for Tartan, leading the team. He's going to have to put the team on his back tonight. The Titans want a solid shot at the Wildcats, and then for Chisago Lakes, it's junior Jack Bakken, 12 goals on the year, 19 points in total. Bakken has been red hot this year for the green and gold. We'll see what the junior can do for his Wildcats tonight. See Bengura skating out. What's up to the beat? It's a might goaltender. Always love to see the younger players get involved with the local high school teams here in the state of Minnesota. Such great development here in the state of hockey. All looking to make their mark down in St. Paul in early March at the XL Energy Center. We see sophomore Braxton Remack will step up. He's looking to get his first point on the year. C. see Cameron Sachs out there. He's got 3 goals on the year. Some depth for the Titans. And then we have Ben Milan. And ladies and gentlemen, here on SEC Sports, we are going to take a quick break for the national anthem. And then when we come back, it'll be Puck Drop here from Tartan Arena. Has ended, but the festivities are just about to get underway here between Chisago Lakes Wildcats and the Tartan Titans. Chisago Lakes in the green jerseys with the gold trim and the black helmets, and the Tartan Titans in the white with black and blue trim is the classic look for Tartan head coach Cole Leach in his 6th season for Tartan. 72-62-4 on the year. We'll see what he can do for his Titans as we see the Wildcats getting their pregame chant, their pregame mantra underway here. Then we have head coach Corey Leshenko for Chisago Lakes. We'll see what he can do with his team on the road. Chisago Lakes has been solid on the road so far this year, but Tartan always tough to play here in their own building. Almost, I'd say, 85% capacity crowd here at Tartan Arena. Players head to the bench. We're just about to get to puck drop here. We'll be Cullen Dorcas on the draw going up against Noah Joyce for Tartan. And we are underway from Tartan Arena. Wildcats control the draw. Sussan Palkowitz, he'll dump it down. Tartan, Sean Duggan looking to break this one out. Getting pestered is Brody Laska. Wildcats gonna look to go the other way. Chipped in center ice, pass doesn't connect to anybody. Speaking of, Tartan able to get their passing going. Nerves here early in the first minute, as both teams look to settle in, get their feet wet a little bit. Don't want to show all the cards just yet. It was a shot by Palkowitz blocked up front by his defenseman and Blum. And we will have icing 55 seconds into the game here, as both teams will go for a change. And last year, February 19th, Tartan took down Chisago Lakes in a close one, 4-3. We'll see how tonight turns out. Will be Nick Jinks on the draw for the Wildcats. He's able to win it back. Jinks without a glove. Sorry, it was Thion without a glove. Shot on. Gonna get pushed away by Bengura. Centering pass, Jinks well behind. Now the Titans down the look to break out. Off the boards. Up ice is Gavin Bush. Bush cuts inside, tries to flip the rink. Don Lowy is Kammermer. Held in by Bertelsen. Bertelsen tried to reach Boots, but Boots didn't have a stick down. Couldn't get a shot on. Bertelsen trying to get that one to the point. He's just going to be pushed away. Boots with it. Button hooks, dumps it back down. Going up ice is Thayen. He can't get the touch. Icing hand is up, and it will be called. Just out of the reach of the senior forward, Drake Thayen. He's got 7 goals on the night. On the year, I should say. And we will have a face-off to Hansen's right here. Ben Milan on the draw for the Titans. Saga wins it back. Blum got this one out. It's going to be Stengel with it. Titan crunched along the boards. Lana had his pocket picked for a moment. See Blum with the push onto a Titan. Blum with it, tries to find up ice, it's Perot. Dassner lost for a moment just inside through the crease. Dassner had Stengel right there on the stoppage and play. And that was probably the best look we've seen so far from Chisago. Just trying to get that trailer set up. Just not in the wheelhouse. Just see the replay right there. Stengel just couldn't get a touch on it. And it will be Cullen Dorcas on the draw. Chisago phenomenal on the faceoff dot tonight already. Coughed up Titans. Gonna collect here. Try to get this one out. Aggressive forecheck gonna be stopped by Hansen behind the net. It's Blum with it. He's looking to get out. He's got Kirko with him. Titans defenseman able to hold that in for a moment. But Blum's gonna work it out. Dump it down. Titans look to regroup. It was Duggan Lawson and escapes for a moment. This is going to allow Chisago get some pressure on. But just as I say, Tartan works the other way. Resch centering pass for Laska. Couldn't connect. Now we see Chisago rushing the other way. With speed, Bakken on his backhand, centering attempt straight to a Tartan defenseman. As that had potential, just didn't have the personnel. Skating up ice is Mayer. He'll dump it down. Mayer pitches along the half wall. Chisago races it. Good move right in front. Was Joe Alexander. He couldn't get it past Bengura. And it seems for Chisago, they've done a little bit of homework and found where the Titans are their weakest. The Titans putting up a fight so far. Glassing out, Titans will regroup. They're gonna dump it back down. Go for a line change. Titans might get caught out here. Alexander shot on, save by Banger, has to get down to the butterfly. And we'll have another stoppage in play. And it seems to me below the faceoff dots is where the Titans struggle on defense here. That's where some breakdowns have happened so far. Jinx on the draw, he'll win it back to Pelkowitz. Pelkowitz saucer pass to Thayen, who fans on it. Chisago just looks to run the cycle, working in the corner, up top. Pelkowitz has to run it down. Titan player falls through the ice. Pale quick shot on, deflected, goes over the crossbar. And a centering pass back to Thayen, back door. He just wasn't ready for it. Went through a stick. Jinx will chip that one down low. Palquist being a menace here on the near side, not letting that puck get past him. So we'll see a soft scrum. It's going to be Aiden Burback to wheel this one around. Chipped up ice. Titans go for a change. Now here come the Wildcats. Chip attempt gets caught in the equipment. Falls to the ice. And it was coughed up by Noah Joyce. Had his stick poked. And a glove save by Bangura. Plenty of happenings in front of the crease. Bangura standing tall. Not phased here yet. See the third line out for the Wildcats. Peralt, Stengel, and Dassner. Titans able to win the drop. They fork this one back. It's Reisch. Reisch off the boards. Up to Joyce. Joyce back to Laska. Backhanded shot went just wide. And now for the Wildcats. They're looking to go in the right direction. Swanson blows a tire. It's going to hinder the breakout. Glamby, now it's a rush. Dassner. Shot sent away by Bangura. Battle along the boards in the corner. 6.5 minutes gone here in the first period. Still looking for our first goal. Titans looking to work this one out. Stengel crushes a Tartan player to the boards. Bertelsen, shot, tried to get deflected up there by Sachs. Couldn't find a connection. Very aggressive forecheck by the Titans. Going to force Osagos to ice the puck here with 9:56 to go. Here in the first period. See that second line out for Tartan. Bush, Bertelsen, and Kammermer. Bush able to win the draw. Now Titans like to get it back into their offensive half. Pelkowitz will say otherwise. Gets set up to Blum. Blum's pass intercepted by Sachs. He'll dump it down. Try to be collected by Bertelsen on the half wall. He'll look to wrap this around. Kistner's there. Back to Bertelsen. DDD pass wheeling around the boards. Bush, good ping along the boards. Thompson trying to work this around. Blum's right there. And the skates kicked out. Titans collide. This could be a chance for the Wildcats. With speed is Bakken trying to do it all himself, but he's forced outside. Wildcats set up the zone. Just as I say so, Titans pushed off. Back into the neutral zone. Wildcats onside. It's Dorcas. Interior pass can be shut down as there is five Titans in the way. Not a high percentage chance that pass was getting through. Good move there by Mayer. Gets his pocket picked. Drop pass right to the glove of Bangura. It was Bobrovsky to send a screamer. But could not beat the glove of the junior. As we see the draw pass into the screen. Nothing doing yet. Good movement. Defenseman without a stick. Good skate. This one is to Vet. That's poked away at the last moment. Joyce with it. As a Titan player kicked away the Wildcat stick. That should have been a penalty. But no penalty was called. Going to be a breakaway. Good the way it saved by Bangura. It was Joe Alexander The junior, one goal on the year. He's had a handful of chances already here in the first period. As we still see the piece of lumber sitting right there. Madden shot's gonna go wide. Swanson with it. Trying to work this one around. Down low, Wildcats get the puck. Looking to get something inside with that stick. Shutting down a lot of passing lanes, just as I say so. The passing lanes open up. And it's Max Bobrowski to put the Wildcats on the board as they now lead 1-0 here in the first period. As what a feed from the half wall. It was Alexander feeding his line mate inside, and just a quick saucer pass inside. Puts the Wildcats in front. Wildcats, they score, they'll immediately take puck possession, they look to do it again. We'll see if they can. Tartan yet to get a shot on net as the scoreboard reads here in the ring. Pass off the boards. Boosh with it, inside pass right into the low slot. Bertelson again just didn't have his stick down. Boosh looking to dump that one down. Will be intercepted. Neutralized play being poked at. Sachs chases this one down. Sachs putting a lot of work in. Working through three Wildcat players. To Cheeto. Sachs shot just wide. That's to Cheeto. Up to the point. Wolves shot wide. Working this one around. As for Tartan, they're getting good pressure in after the last goal from Max Bobrowski for the Wildcats. Speaking of the Wildcats, they're forced to ice it here as Titans beginning to clamp down on offense. Wildcats defense getting a bit of a breather. Both teams get line changes in, fresh legs out on the ice. Will be Brody Alaska on the draw. Alaska unable to win it. Wildcats trying to wrap it around. Takes a weird hop off the stanchion. Wrap around attempt, gonna get covered up by Jack Hansen. Haven't said his name a lot tonight. But he has finally seen some action. We see Joyce on the draw for Tartan now. He'll win it back. Along the half wall, kept in by Mayer. He's got Kistner with him on the far side. He's able to get it down low. To the low slot was Reach. Laska tried to get something into the slot, nothing doing there. Wildcats going the other way. Dassner waits, waits some more, tries to go back door. Had Perrault wide open all by himself. Just a little too much heat on that pass. Clearing attempt, fanned on. Perrault shot blocked by Bingura. Slick and skates over along the boards. It's gonna be the senior Nate Blum to collect. Swanson skates in, waits, tries to go low corner. Shut down by the junior goaltender. And we'll stay at 1-0 here. 4:48 to go in the first period. And for the Wildcats, they're 6-3-1 after scoring the opening goal. It's a good spot to be in. Faceoff held in by Pelkwitz. Titans playing with a bit of fire, trying to skate that puck out near the front of their net. Chisago Down low, working it behind the net. Up to the point. Blum fans on it. Was swatted at. Going to trickle out to the near side. Down low in the corner. See a plethora of players trying to jam this puck out. Mariston had it for a moment. Good touch pass. Streaking up ice. Darwin called for offsides and probably the right call there. Just timing wasn't there for the Titans. And we'll have a face-off to Hansen's left in the neutral zone. I am incorrect. It'll be right in front of us here. Opposite, Palquitz, he'll get the face-off, dump it back down. Ingura will slow it down. Titans look to work this one out of the boards. Chipped in front. Palquitz shot deflected. Still down low, bouncing. Palquitz have another rip at it, blocked. Up high, said puck didn't even make it to the net. Couple passes by Gavin Bush were blocked. Darton forced to reset things. Bush. Interior. Drop pass. Oh, good move by Sean Duggan. Duggan 10 points on the year. Just needed another touch. As we have a delayed penalty on Chisago. They touch up immediately. And it will be a hook on the Wildcats. Palquitz going to the box as he'll take a 2-minute rest in the sin bin. 3:02 to play here in the first period. Wildcats currently lead the shots on goal 12-3. We'll see if the Titans can put more on here. Get some dangerous looks. There was a backhand attempt by Cameron right in front. Duggan. Down low to Cameron. Back to Duggan. Down low is Joyce. Bush has to step up in the corner. Bouncing the low slot. Reisch can't hold it in. As the Titans, they'll dump and chase. Be jammed into the corner. Gets to the point. Slap redirected up front. Was Joyce off the stick of Duggan. Joyce trying to work something long. But it'll be chipped out by Cullen Dorcas. Bush, more space. Walks in. Trying to get around the defenseman in the corner. Can't do so. As Tim Madden was having other ideas. Joyce and Madden going back and forth. Joyce gets it. It squirts out. The Titans force to play chase here once again. 40 seconds remain on their man advantage. Titans circling to get the look they want. Dumping this one down as Connor Wops. And immediately forced out by Chisago. Titans look to go again. 15 seconds now. One final rush here for the man advantage. Going to be dumped down. Wops to hold it in. Just going to flip that one back behind the net. Riddleson shot will be saved off of the stick of Meyer into Hansen's glove. And with 58 seconds remaining here in the first period, we'll have another faceoff. Will be to Jack Hansen's left. Dorcas on the draw, wins it back. Shot straight into the glove of Hansen. He's ready. start putting up a fight here late in the first period. Wildcats win the draw. It's back and force this one out. This one again thrown up ice by Milan. Off the chest of Wops, going to be kept in. Chased down on the corner, 20 seconds, 25 seconds, I should say. Sago clears straight to the stick of Laska. Laska tries to go one on three, turned out just about as you expected. Forced outside the dots, coughs off the puck. Dorcas down low, waits. That shot had potential, was deflected, goes the other way. As the clock winds down, we'll hear the buzzer as Jack Bacher took a stick to the helmet. He looks to be all right. He's shaking it off. And after one period here, Chisago Lakes Wildcats lead the Tartan Titans 1-0 after one. We'll be back with you.
As a parent, you know you can't prevent every accident. Play it safe with the right equipment. Add a mouthguard to your child's sports or recreational equipment list to help prevent the impact of a painful and costly facial injury. Mouthguard should be fitted so it does not misalign the jaw, lightweight, strong, easy to clean, properly sized, covering the upper and lower teeth and gums. If your child does sustain a facial injury, seek an evaluation from an oral and maxillofacial surgeon. OMSs are experts in handling injuries to the face, mouth, and jaws. Learn more at myoms.org.
As a veteran, you get a lot of advice, but wisdom's harder to come by. A lot of people imagine themselves in our shoes without understanding the weight on our shoulders. The truth is, few can understand the pressure of finding your own way after serving in the military. But few isn't none. You've got support. You can't control the chaos, but you can chart your way through it. Steady yourself. Take a breath. You're not alone. Learn more at maketheconnection.net.
Today, we face an unprecedented crisis. Tens of millions of refugees have been forced from their homes. But you can make a difference. Turn disruption and despair to hope and opportunity. Even small amounts make a big difference. Provide shelter, support, or jobs in your community. The more we understand, the greater sense of belonging we create. Act now. Visit supportcrisisrelief.org.
Hi, I'm Smokey Bear, and I made an assistant to help you out. Because only you can prevent wildfires.
Hey, Assistant Smokey Bear, call me Papa Bear, because I'm grilling up dinner. Do you get it?
Yes, good job.
So, what should I do with all these coals?
Don't just toss them out. Put them in a metal container, because those embers can start a wildfire.
I understand. The stakes are high.
Ha, 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 ha.
See, Smokey thinks I'm funny.
Thank you. Thanks. Great having you.
Incredible women. I wish they had those kind of cool careers for women when we were growing up.
So in this flashback, we're all the same age?
Yeah.
What does everyone want to be when they grow up?
If I say two jobs, do I get extra credit?
No.
I want to make immersive video games.
I want to revolutionize 3D printing.
I want to analyze data from the cloud.
I want to be a meteor.
You mean meteorologist?
No.
That's great, Al. Follow your dreams.
For the record, I was a baby in the 70s.
Welcome to the intermission report here on SEC Sports. Currently, the Chisago Lakes Wildcats lead 1-0 over the Tartan Titans after 17 minutes of play. As we'll have a quick look at some stats, some highlights, and even some section standings as playoffs are just around the corner. As we see Alexander for the Wildcats put a solid rip on, just couldn't get one to go through, and one for Tartan. A quick wraparound was shut down by the Wildcats defense, made it easy for Jack Hansen on the save. And what a move by Sean Duggan. Just one touch away, and here we see the goal. We see Alexander right into the low slot, really deflected by Max Bobrovsky. Puts his Wildcats on the board midway through that first period, and that's how we got put up 1-0 here. Shots on goal. Wildcats lead it 12-6. The one power play opportunity going to Tartan. They were unable to capitalize, unable to get any shots on their power play as they really just could not get their offense to settle in. And then we'll take a look at our section standings here, our 4AA standing. It's the big schools, so the White Bear Lake Bears on top. They're hosting Hockey Day here this Saturday. They're 13-3 on the year. And they will be playing the Hill Murray Pioneers, who are having a shocking slump year to say. It's been an absolute disaster for the Pioneers. They're 7-8-1 on the year. See Stillwater there as well. And Tartan 2-15. They're having a rough ride here in the 22-23 season, but we'll see what they can do to turn their season around. Stillwater and Gentry there up top as well. Then in four single A. If it's correct, yes, the Mata Medi Zephyrs 11-4 on the year. They're currently ranked fourth in the single A action. You got Two Rivers, who's having a phenomenal year this year, 14-3. And then you see Chisago Lakes sitting there in third, 7-6-1. They're ahead of St. Paul Academy, Simley, South St. Paul, and St. Paul Johnson, as well as St. Paul Highland Park, where my mom went to high school many, many years ago. But Chisago Lakes, they're looking solid right now. Right now, they're, if all goes well, they're set for a semifinal matchup against Two Rivers. We'll see if that'll happen. But right now, the Mata Medi Zephyrs looking stellar so far this year. And ladies and gentlemen, Zamboni's just about to finish up here on the ice. We're going to throw to another short break here on SEC Sports. When we come back, it'll be the start of the second period between the Wildcats and the Titans.
Hi, I'm Marcel Spears. Keeping our global neighborhood safe is a tough job, one made just a bit safer with the help of America's brave military dogs. These dogs, who often take the same risks and make the same sacrifices as our human warriors, keep our troops safe by sniffing out bombs and IEDs, locating enemy positions, and bringing a sense of comfort and home to an almost unimaginable circumstance. Yet, when these brave canine heroes retire, they're not always given the same treatment as our military VIPs, and are too often left overseas. American Humane works to bring home these valiant dogs and reunite them with the people who mean the most to them, their handlers, so they can enjoy happy, healthy, well-deserved retirements. To learn how you can help America's four-footed heroes, visit AmericanHumane.org.
Where did the time
Done the hard part. You quit smoking. Now do the easy part and get scanned for lung cancer. If you smoked, you may still be at risk, but early detection could save your life. Talk to your doctor and learn more at savedbythescan.org.
Sometimes you can lose your faith, you can lose your mind, lose your grip, get stripped of your pride, till you don't know how you're gonna stay alive. Hey, hey, I got you. Hey, hey, I got you. I'll be there, stop bleeding. I'll be there, start the healing. I will give you what you need, and I'll be right there. I got you back, I got you.
Today, we face an unprecedented crisis. Tens of millions of refugees have been forced from their homes. But you can make a difference. Turn disruption and despair to hope and opportunity. Even small amounts make a big difference. Provide shelter, support, or jobs in your community. The more we understand, the greater sense of belonging we create. Act now. Visit supportcrisisrelief.org.
Second period here on SCC Sports for your boys hockey matchup between the Chisago Lakes Wildcats and the Tartan Titans. I'm your commentator, Earnhardt Michael Jaworski. And after one, the Wildcats lead 1-0 off of a goal from Max Bobrowski. And we'll see here in the second period if Tartan can put another one on the board or if the Wildcats will extend their lead. Ben Benguras looks solid all night long, except for the one slip up from the Bobrowski goal. And puck drop is a few seconds away here. Got the band playing here at the Tartan Arena. Very lively here. Nice little rink on the east side of the cities. Here in Oakdale, I should say. As we see the senior Colin Kammerer right there, head coach for the Wildcats, Corey Lashenko. Doing a solid job coaching his team so far. As we get ready for the middle frame. And we are underway. Will be Noah Joyce to dump this one down. Laska and Reese will play chase. Be shut down by Doug on that half wall. Joyce. And a wrap around for Reach. Got Laska right there. Blum will pick it up behind his net. Chipped out. Is that going to go for icing? No, it's not. Waved off. Bengura just happened to push that one up ice. Wildcats have to touch up. Darton pokes at it. Puck at the rafter, it's gonna stay in the play. Now Chisago Lakes into the settle things down. Dorcas cuts inside, gets it poked away. Kirkrow inside, back in. It's going to be sent to the corner. And this one going to be flipped up ice, but it's on net. Icing waved off. Titans go for a line change. Soft pass up the Kirkrow. Kirkrow back in. Backhands blocked up front. And this one's going to get waved off for icing. It was right in the middle of the Chisago Lakes line change. Madden circles around his net. They chip this one up. He'll be met by Mariston. Now, Tart working in the office zone. Mariston, that's offside just barely. The junior defenseman and Mariston got to control that puck a little bit more. Shook his head a little bit, skating back. 15-15 to play here in the second period. Will be Bertelsen on the draw for the Titans. Titans will win it back. Cammer couldn't get anything going. We see a delayed penalty. It's going to be a high stick. We'll see who's going to the box. Is it going to be a Chisago Lakes player? Yes, it will be. It's going to be Andrew Swanson, the junior. Going to sit for 2 minutes. This is why at a young age, players got to wear cages or bubbles. It's all about safety. Now we'll see what Titans can do on their second power play chance. From top of the circle, it was Mayer who couldn't get the puck in his wheelhouse. Bertelsen. Bertelsen down low, going to get helped out by Sachs. Duggan skates in, sliding save by Hansen. That's 25 seconds in. We'll have a stoppage. Bertelsen, the sophomore on the draw. Shot from Wasp, fanned on. A couple players collide, puck's gonna squirt out to the other end. And a cross check onto a Titan player. It's gonna be 17 to Connor Wasp. It was behind the play too, so really unneeded. As we see Wasp catching his breath. Well, 4-on-4 here for a minute 21. A little more open ice here. We'll see if things open up. Titan player knocked down, and icing will be called, as I don't believe Tartan realized there are still technically even strength here. 111 on the call. We see senior Cullen Dorcas. He's got 11 assists on the year. Dorcas can't win the drawback. We'll be back. He tries to go 1-on-3. Almost cuts its way through. Heads up. Back and falls on top of Bengura. All seems to be well. Dirt, a little for a short line change here. We'll be Joyce on the draw for the Titans. Joyce off the wall with Reisch. Pass intercepted. Inside Bakken. All alone. Shut down. Second attempt. Sliding save as a Tartan defender slides in. Titans come back from the brink of oblivion. Find themselves still down by one. Good high save there by Hansen. Wildcat knocked down. Bush up top. Shot right to the pad. Low deflection, just wide from Gavin Bush. Hansen trying to collect himself, finally back on both feet. Reach, trying to work something inside, covered up, no. By Hansen. Now Mariston, he's gonna lose the puck. Back into, I don't think he's been on the bench. He's been seemingly on the ice for the entirety of this period so far. And Chisago goes to full strength and immediately, I think they're gonna get called for a trip here. As it's gonna be number 17, Ben Kirkrow. And for Chisago, he did a great job on the 4-on-4. And you find yourself back to square one. So it'll be 4-on-4 once more for 30 seconds. And then it'll be another Titans power play. Going to work some space for himself. Up ice is Drake Thion. Thion just going to stay on this puck, be a pest. Hansen collected for a moment. Swanson tied up behind his own net. Titans back to full strength here. Down low, Duggan. He's going to lose possession. Good pass to see Wildcats going the other way. Shot blocked, still in the low slot. Still in the feet, we see a Wildcat player go down. Wildcat skate in, it's Swanson. He'll just kick that back out. Dump back, and that was almost on net. Almost scary there for a moment for Bangura. Now it's Mayer. Dump and chase going to be captained by Reish. No, Mayer will collect again. He's looking to really quarterback this power play, get something going with 40 seconds to go. See the dump in. Held in by Bush on the half wall. Short inside, going to be a bouncy puck, goes the other way. And this power play not as successful for the Titans as their previous one. Bush works inside, gets a stick in front of his shot, and just gets sent away to the corner. 10 seconds remain now on the man advantage for the Titans. And the Wildcats are looking to get one on the shorthand. Swanson, pass back, shot, weight deflected, wide was Jinx. As good patience from Nick Jinx. That one's going to go the other way. With speed, Bakken, man, this kid has some jets. Shot deflected off the glass. Wildcat player takes the tumble. Heads up, pass going to get called for icing. No. Jinx going to try to work this one out. Circling with it is Laska. It's pushed off. Now it's Sack circling. Cross ice pass to Duggan, kept it in. Joyce shot, didn't make it to the net. Sacks couldn't finish, tries to wrap around, gets pushed out by Blum. Duggan. Thornton gotta be careful. Almost too many men on the ice. Pick play behind the net doesn't work out. Will be Blum to pick up. Now almost a 2-1 rush the other way. Bakken looking for his full school laser to the glove of Bangura. And Bakken with 12 goals on the year, yet to find number 13. Oh, what a save by Bangura, just flashing the leather. Saga wins the draw. Go work this one around. held it in for a moment. Icing waved off. Up top, it's Mariston. Mayer. Shot takes a couple bounces. It's a wide remackle down low. See the third line for the Titans. Getting some action, touch, pass. Titans touch up. Into the neutral zone. Mayer up into the netting. The shot was deflected up in the high slot. Well, the stoppage, 8:50 to go. Here in the second period. First period, the Titans looked a bit sluggish as they've only scored 10 goals this season in the first period. But here in the second, where they've scored 13 so far this season, they seem to have a little more pep in their step. Heads up pass. Will be sent down to the corner. Titans look to rush. Wildcats offsides. They got a touch up. And not in the loop was Dassner. So we'll have another stoppage of play here. Chisago has scored 16 goals here in the second period. Not their most prolific. They're most prolific in the third, with 21 goals in the third. Let's see what the Wildcats can do here in the second period. Pass right down low. Vangura has to cover up. Could be a 3-1 rush the other way. Boosh. He gets his stick. Poke puck will trickle to the corner. Gets that one to the half wall. Mariston's shot blocked. Completely ate up by Dassner. Speaking of Dassner, he's got some room. He's going to have a teammate with him. Dassner waits a low shot. Just wide. Net comes off. It's Maureen's. As it was Griffin Perrault back door. But we'll stay 1-0. Pass got collected in the skate. It'll trickle up ice. Wildcats collect. Jammed that along the near side wall. Madden will button hook. Backhand pass that one up to Dorcas. Kirkrow. Fed that one inside the Bakken, who just had a little too much speed there. Couldn't pump the brakes. Interior pass, second, third attempt. Still not in. As Swanson, Dorcas, and Backhand all had a swat at it. But could not find the back of the net. Titans chip this one down. We'll work this one around. Poked at, swatted away by Hansen to the far corner. Low sliding shot by Wasp. Gonna be sent away. Wildcats work through the neutral zone. Up ice pass to Sachs. He'll rifle one out over the crossbar. Tevet, Boosh gets his shot attempt blocked. Bocknat for a moment. Sachs, touch pass. Can't get anything going. Titans force a play chase. Bakken poked the stick out. Wanted the penalty. Didn't get it. Darn with it. He'll push it forward. Darn to Vet and Cheeto. Fourth line out there for the Titans. And icing waved off here. Swanson gonna pressure. Looks like it'll be Thompson. Titan falls to the ice. And Sachs is trying to dump this one down, but he had a stick tied up. With speed, here comes Chisago. Blum. centering pass back to Thompson, just wasn't there. Now it's the Titans with some speed. Bertelsen lost, tries to button hook in the corner. He's crunched along the boards. Morrison, second shot attempt straight to the glove of Hansen. This is the first attempt for Morrison. He fanned on it, faked out Hansen for a moment. As we see, so the beginnings of some extracurriculars there after the whistle. Boosh took a couple more swats at it. 5-10 here in the second period. Madden. So it's Duggan looking for something while another stoppage as Hansen will cover up. The JV matchup was a high scoring one. It was 5-5 at the end of three periods. No overtime was played. And so far, the varsity matchup seems to be the same story here. Close action, plenty of it. Wildcats work this one around. Just trying to get some open space. But the forecheck for Tartan, very aggressive. All five players inside the blue line. Titans have to touch up. As we see, both teams going back and forth, just looking to get something going. Duggan gonna flip this one way up ice, will be collected right at the center faceoff dot by Swanson. Chisago goes for a line change. Lets it pass to Cameron. Cameron couldn't get anything going down low. Yard sale behind the net as a Chisago player loses a glove and a stick. Try to go short side. Did he find the back of the net? No, it's waved off. Darn said it was in the back of the net. We'll have to take a second look here. As we saw a Tartan player half celebrate. Ref waved it off. We'll see Laska have a short chat with the ref here. As we see here, this near side. Oh, it just sat on the far post. Couldn't find its way in the back net. And then it was just a Chisago player and Stengel to push the net off its moorings. Dangerous DDB pass. Shot Hansen well outside his crease. Kept in by Tartan. Swatted down up front. Be Reese with it down low. Reese still working at it. So one gets past Mayer. And Bakken again with just unbelievable speed. Seemingly can beat out any Titan player in a one-on-one skate. Reese with it. Trying to work this one around. And try to get to the point. Duggan. Cross ice feed gets blocked up front from Wosp. Oh, Duggan forced to back skate here. Swat that will be collected by Blum. Blum knocks down a Titan player. Knocks him to his seat again. Blum and Tachito going at it. Thompson had to collect himself. Dorcas right there. One will force it just right. Bakken's on the ground. As everything seems to be happening here this shift for both sides here late in the second. Brock Thompson will chase this down. And the skates of Sachs here along the half wall. pops out. Jinx had a touch on it. Now Darton looking to go the way. Mayer chipped up almost into the glove of Madden. That's going to be icing. The minute 43 remaining here in the second. The lone goal coming from Max Borowski, putting his Wildcats in the lead. That has been all the scoring we've had so far. Just about 100 seconds remaining here in the second period. So a neutral face-off draw. Thornton had possession of it for a moment. Wildcats are flying, it's a finish attempt! And the Wildcats on the road lead 2-0. Just like that. Brock Thompson doubles up for the Wildcats on just a second chance attempt as Bengura left the rebound attempt wide open. All by himself was Thompson in front of the net. As cliche as it is, good things happen when you get to the front of the net. And Thompson gets his fifth goal on the year. Gives the Wildcats a bit more of a cushion here going into the second intermission. Edge will have another face-off here. Sligo wins the draw, deflects off a stick. Marison will throw it down low. Pinned along the board is Bush. Shot caught up into a Chisago player. He's laying on top of the puck. Gets it poked out. Final minute remaining here in the second period. Chisago had to be careful not completely cover the puck, as that would have been a delay of game. Chisago trying to get something out on this far board. They finally do so for a moment, but at the cost of possession, heads up, that's going to go over the glass. And behind the boards with exactly 40 seconds here in the second period. See head coach Cole Leach there for Tartan. Trying to get his Titans back into this one. See if they can cut the deficit before the period ends. As we see a delayed penalty, potentially no. Ref had his hand that looked to be for delayed offsides. Tartan tries to go glass and out, but Bakken's right there. One final rush for Tartan. 7 seconds. Duggan works inside, going to be swatted away by Hansen. And after 35, Chisago Lakes leads 2-0 now. Off of a goal from Brock Thompson. And here in SCC Sports, don't go anywhere, we'll be right back with you.
In life, there are things that suck, but we do them anyway. Family photo sessions with matching outfits suck, but we do it anyway. And you know what else really sucks? Getting screened for cancer. But you've got to do it anyway. Screening can save your life from cancer, or even help prevent certain types of cancer. For more information, visit GetScreenedForCancer.org.
When times get dark, we can't see the help that's all around us. When you don't know where to turn, let 211 be your guiding light.
How can I help you?
Our guides are ready to connect you with the help you need. For help with food, healthcare, mental health, and other resources, call 211 or visit 211.org. 211. Get connected, get help.
Life doesn't always give you time to change the outcome. Prediabetes does. One in three adults has prediabetes. And you could be one of them. There are usually no signs for prediabetes, so it's important to understand your risk. With early diagnosis, prediabetes can be reversed. And you can change the outcome. Take the 1 minute prediabetes risk test today. Go to doihaveprediabetes.org.
When it comes to making plans, you are the best. Those 9 months were also 273 days of planning. What about your daughter's first costume party? It was out of this world. And let's not forget those barbecues you plan in detail for your family and your more vegetarian by the day best friends. That surprise party for your parents' golden anniversary? You get the golden planning. The same way you plan each detail for those moments, start planning to protect you and your loved ones from a natural disaster. Sign up for local weather and emergency alerts. Prepare an emergency kit and make a family communications plan. Protecting your family is the best plan you can make.
If you're buzzed and doing this, to make yourself feel okay to drive,
ZWX.
You're not okay to drive.
YGKLVW. Regular you.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Intermission Report here on SCC Sports. Currently, the Chisago Lakes Wildcats lead the Tartan Titans 2-0 as it was Brock Thompson, the senior forward, to put the Wildcats up now by 2. And here we'll have some highlights, some stats, and a little bit more here in the intermission. This should be a great rip there from Duggan, collected by Hansen from well up top. Duggan's had great vision so far. Then we see Josh Bakken all by his lonesome. Bakken has had some phenomenal speed all night. We see Nick Jinks with a look. That gets deflected up top. Another attempt on Ben-Gurion. He's been solid all night. Another glove saved there by Hansen. Drop down. We see a corner look as it was Brock Thompson, the cleanup. And put the Wildcats up by 2 after 2. Shots are 26-20 in favor of Chisago Lakes. See Tartan getting some more offensive opportunities in that one. Both teams combined 0-4 on the man advantage. coming into tonight. Both teams were 19% on the power play. To put that into perspective there, but Tartan having three more man advantage opportunities, I should say. And then we're taking a look at the rest of the schedule here for Tartan. You're at St. Thomas. You got Cambridge, Asante, Simley, South St. Paul, at Somerset over in Wisconsin, Owatonna and Hastings. Seems the schedule lightens up a bit here for the Titans as the season begins, as the postseason gets to be a little bit closer here. And then we'll take a quick glance at what the Wildcats have coming up down the line. St. Paul Academy, Dodge County, Two Rivers, Pine City, Cambridge, Asante, Northern Edge, Princeton, Minneapolis, Providence Academy, and Simley. And for Chisago Lakes, there looks to be a lot of winnable games there. Two Rivers, the one ranked opponent I can see. Two Rivers, I want to say ranked ninth in single A. They're over down in West St. Paul. So for the Wildcats, plenty of winnable games. Going to be close as they're sitting as the three seed right now in their section. They're looking to improve that just a little bit. And for us here at SEC Sports, we're going to throw it to a bit of a break. And when we come back, it'll be the final frame. It'll be the third period, ladies and gentlemen. Don't go anywhere.
As a scientist, I know by the time she takes her first breath, 9 billion more tons of carbon pollution will be in the air. When she takes her first steps, wildfires will have burned millions more acres she could have explored. The day she gets her first pet, there are thousands of newly extinct species she'll never meet. The night she forgets to call, the night of her first heartbreak, her future home floods for the first of many times. By the time a child born today goes to college, it may be too late to leave them the world we promised. Our window to act on climate change is like watching them grow up. We blink and we miss it.
My name is Gary Parker. I served as a Cavalry Scout and a military policeman in the United States Army for 20 years.
When I was a Cavalry Scout, we had a young lieutenant that came in. Great guy, but he moved on, got promoted to lieutenant colonel, went on to Afghanistan, and I was able to keep in contact. And I'd wake up one morning, go on social media, and there's that post you don't want to see. For whatever reason, he took his own life. Nobody knows why he did it. And if there's something that we could have done to prevent it from happening, safe gun storage can prevent gun suicide because it's that added step to get to your firearm that might just give somebody a moment of reflection on what they're doing. As a veteran, we need to be ambassadors to people that don't have the knowledge that we have. Anytime you're not storing a weapon safely, you're putting yourself and your community at risk. Service never stops.
I'll be here to hear what's on your mind. Take this time to talk and get it right. You know I'll be there all your life. When you need me, I'll be by your side. By your side.
And every day is a different day. Everything isn't everything. Even when you think things could never ever be the same. Don't be scared of the world, I'll be here to stay.
By your side.
Even when your heart ain't listening, or your mind takes you a different way, towards a different path, all you gotta do is sit and ask.
When you need me, I'll be by your side.
When the adults in a child's life talk early and often about the dangers of underage drinking, the message gets stronger every time.
I'll be by your side.
Talk, they hear you.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
you're not going to get it all right. Just make sure you nail the big stuff.
Mama!
Like making sure your kids are in the right seat for their age and size. Get it right at nhtsa.gov/the right seat. You're not going to get it all right. Just make sure you nail the big stuff, like making sure your kids are in the right seat for their age and size. Get it right at nhtsa.gov/the right seat.
Welcome back to SCC Sports for the third period for this boys hockey matchup between the Saugo Lakes Wildcats and the Tartan Titans. Saugo Lakes currently leads 2-0 after two periods from goals from Bobrovsky and Thompson. And right away, as Scared us through their pre-period warm-up, we see a little bit of confrontation, as that's kind of been the tone here late in the period. Or late in the second period, players getting each other's faces. Only the third matchup between these two teams in history, but seems to be already a bit of bad blood. Bit of a rivalry brewing, per se. The first 35 have been stellar. We'll see what the last 17 minutes will show off here, as the Titans look to get on the board and the Saugo Lakes of Wildcats look to keep the opposition at bay. Keep the home crowd quiet. We'll see what they can do. It will be Joyson Dorcas on the draw. Tartan wins it out, heads up. That was almost over the glass. Just hits that last bit of netting right in front of the band and we'll say Tartan student section. As well, another face-off draw right up here at center ice. Wildcats will win this one out. And will be chipped up ice. Icing is waved off. Wolves pat it for a moment. Tartan looking to get something going. But Kirkrow has other ideas. Kirkrow, he's thrown to the ice. Duggan had a chance at it. Now Tartan looking to regroup. Titans chip that one out. Can't get the touch in neutral ice. So he'll circle for working it up ice once again. Reach on his backhand, button hooks back. He's pushed down to the ice, no call. And Dorcas rushing the other way. He's got back and with him. Thompson, low slot, tried to fight back and back door. He was right there. Just could not pull the trigger. Wildcats are up by two. They're looking for more. Tartan ducks that one down. Looking to chase Glasson out. Going to get past Matt Kissinger, and we'll have icing with 15:31 here remaining in the game. Tartan, they've had chances for offensive pressure shots by period. A lot better in that second period for the Titans. 14 compared to the 6 in the first. Saugo Lakes 14 to the 12 in the first. Saugo Lakes looking steady, but the Titans gaining momentum. Bertelsen gonna stop the momentum on the half wall. On the board, trying to get something going. Low angle shot bounces right back in front of Hansen. As a Titan player hit the near post, and it bounced right out in front of senior Jack Hansen. He was able to keep his composure, keep the puck out of the back of the net. Faceoff will be to Hansen's left. Titans will win that out. That one up high hits the glass behind Hansen. Mayer's able to hold this one in. Madden down low, no, Boosh. Has it, he's gonna get offside. Titans have to touch up here. Wildcats, a little bit of breathing room out of sync where Chisago Lake's icing waved off. This Burback was right there. Boosh looks up, ice, sees no one's there. He's gonna dump it down, go for a change. A lot of stretch passes here to start the third. It's to Cheeto. Down low, trying to wrap this one around. Button hooks the other way. Loses it behind the net. Four players down low. Cheeto still has it. It's Milan. Cheeto to the point. And Burback will work it around to Cheeto now. Down low, he's tied up with Dunleavy. Milan takes a swack at it. Burback threw one on, just pushed away. Now Swanson looking to make room for himself. Heads up pass, that's swatted down. A couple players collide as the puck was up high. And looks like Titans called for offside just barely. 13:48 here. Remaining in the game. Titans having some good looks. And after two, Chisago Lakes, after leading after two, I should say, they were 6-0. So for head coach Curry Lashenko, he knows that his team can close out games. But a two-goal lead, not the most comfortable lead. It's a little, it kind of lulls you to a false sense of reality, as you can't get too comfortable as if the opposition puts one on the board. It's only a one-goal lead, and then you got your hands full. Puck will hit the netting. We'll slow down the action before we reset, get things going. Top line out there for Tartan, Laska, Joyce, and Reisch. Wildcats win the draw. Belkowitz at it for a moment down low. Poked at was Wolfsp. Whoops, up top. Titans almost looking like they have three defensemen the way they're lined up. Another stretch pass by Chisago going to get shut down. Belkowitz working his way up ice. Gets some a little bit of help from Joe Alexander. I'm going to get wrapped around. Clearing attempt by the Titans, short. Oh, Bangura blows a tire behind his own net. Luckily, he had three teammates right there with him. Bakken racing this one around, almost takes a hit up high. Center attempts that there. Madden, backdoor feed to Dorcas. Couldn't get anything going. Soft pass there by Chisago. Big Kirkrow just to dump it in. Kammerer working along the half wall. Gets this one up ice with a little bit of speed. Shot by Kammerer. Second attempt right into the low slot. Slapped at just wide. Kammerer tries by the back of the door. He does. Bounces off the back wall behind the net, and it's just right place, right time for Colin Kammerer. And the Titans get within one. What awareness by the senior. As the initial shot was wide on the other side from Mariston. And then Kammerer just gets it from his backhand straight to his forehand. Beats Hansen on the post. Titans on the board. Camber gets his fifth of the year. And we're going to see Sean Duggan go to the box for what looks to be elbowing. As a Wildcat took a wild tumble. And for the Titans, that's just going to kill your momentum. You get a big even strength goal just like that. And now it's just kind of thrown to the wayside. He's got a lock up on defense here. Osago Lake, 19% on the power play this year so far. They'll look to improve that here. As it'll be a roughing penalty on the Titans. He's balking. Man, this kid's quick. Skates around, just trying to set the zone. Struggles to slow himself down. Wildcats behind the net. Jinx is pinched to the boards. Jinx down low. Dart player loses a stick for a moment. Gonna allow some open spaces. Blum pushes it back in. And Bertelsen couldn't clear. Now this one does, but straight to the glove of Blum. Gets it up ice. The Dork is just offside. As we'll see where the faceoff goes, looks like it's going to go to the opposite end here. The neutral zone. A minute and some change here on the man advantage for the Wildcats. Darton able to win the draw back and force it down behind the net of Chisagos, make him go the full length of the ice here. Perot, inside touch pass, straight on the Stengel stick, just a soft deflection, try to get swatted down with Swanson. And Joyce racing down had a feed right back into the low slot, just didn't have a teammate there. Joyce gets back. As Peral tried to do it himself, and Gurner will cover up. So there are a couple players on the ground. 27 seconds remain here. On the man advantage. Barton able to win the draw. They immediately button hook that one out. Again, making Chisago go the full length of the ice here, really making them work for it. Dorcas, centering pass for Bakken. Player knocked to the ice, that's all it needs. And that should just about do it for the Chisago power play. Shot from Milan, well wide, punched away by Hansen. Jinx making his way up ice. He's gonna get pushed off, no trip, just kinda loses a bit of an edge there. Poke touch. Sachs has the feet. Immediately saved in the back of the net. Titans tie it up. As that might be a bit controversial. Looks like Hansen had that one covered up. We're gonna have to wait and see, but just like that, Cameron Sachs, with his fourth of the year, makes it two apiece. We'll look at the review here. This will be a good look. Zach gets that one through. It's on the top of the pad. I can't believe it. Good eyes there by Cameron Sachs. That puck was just arrested on top of the pad. Hansen thought he had the play dead, but apparently not. And it is a perfectly even scoreboard, 909, 2-2, and 29 shots apiece. As all of a sudden, things have gotten very interesting here, and I think for the Wildcats, they really just kind of let their foot off the throttle. And for the Titans, they didn't really have anything to lose. They went for it, and it paid off as they hit Pater twice here in the third period. Tie this game up. Two apiece. Now it's Kammerer trying to get this one around the defender. Shut down by Hansen, short side. Well, the Titans really playing like a well-oiled machine right now. Wildcats, maybe who have been laid back a little bit. Got to step it up here. Shot punched out. This one's going to go for icing. No. Off the boards. It was Reach who was caught up on a Wildcat. As that one's going to go into the bench. And we'll have another stoppage. 8:04 to go here in the final frame. Faceoff will be at the center dot. One straight back. Mangura has to cycle that one around. Berkowitz at it. Laska pressuring down low. Just rips it away from the Wildcat defender. Now, for Chisago, they're playing a bit sluggish here. As Reish gets pinned along the boards, almost gets thrown to the ice. Player lost the glove for Chisago. Titans run into each other. Now they're looking to go the other way. As icing's going to be called as a couple players couldn't get away from each other. No call blown as plenty of hands went up in front of me. Game getting a bit chippy here in the remaining minutes. Titans work down low off the half wall. Get that one out to Cheetah. He's got to Vet with him. Swanson. Up to Zorkis. That's right into the bench. Almost hit his own coach. But head coach Lashenko able to quickly get out of the way. Well, the just under 7 minutes here. To go in the third period. Bertelsen able to win the draw. Kammerer. Most recent goal scorer trying to work this one around. Well, shot into Sick Hammer right there, back door, second, third attempt, fourth attempt, can't get it in the back of the net. As the Titans swarm in the low slot. Looking to take the lead, unable to do so. The second line for the Titans. Really putting in work. Kammerer gets a stick tied up. Kammerer has it back. It's kind of a puck magnet right now. Making defenders miss, and it was Bertelsen who had his stick tied up right there. And Kammerer will dump it down. Pass up to Jinx, well off the mark. Mayer gonna thump it back. Titans have switched something up on their forecheck, and it has worked so far. Jinx, pass to himself, gonna throw one on net. Puck makes his way into the corner. off the boards. Joyce, one to beat, gets it inside. Lasko back to Joyce, skates with it. Tries a backdoor feed, couldn't get anything going. Now it's his captain. Plum goes top shelf, back the net. Puts the Wildcats in the lead. You hear the ping of the pipe and the roar of the crowd. But the Wildcats are up 3-2. What a rip from Nate Blum. That's only his second of the year. And it couldn't have come at a bigger moment. As we see Blum step in, time, space, all you need. And you can tell in the replay, man, is he excited. The Titans had this thing tied up. They got two quick goals. Now they got to earn a second one. Skates this one in. Down low, it's Darwin. Can go up top, Duggan. Blum hits his own defender. Darwin took a poke at it. That one's going to go for icing. With 4:30 remain. It was Nate Blum to break the tie. And we see Bangura still in net. We'll see when the Titans pull their goalie. Stengel tried to chip it out. Bertelsen, shot collected by Hansen. We'll take a couple seconds off the clock. As we see Tartan assistant coaches drawing something up. Soon that will be implemented. Holding the zone was Wasp. High slot attempt. Gonna go just wide off of Duggan. Working it down low. Wasp is gonna hit the back of a Wildcat. Good block. They'll just keep that one in. Madden tries to poke it out. Wildcats can't clear. Tired legs. And Wasp and Doug just not on the same page. Poke attempt, 3:30 remain. Reesh. Still in the corner with it. Trying to skate past Stengel. Mayer one deflected just wide. Shot blocked up front of Chisago, doing a great job getting in front of pucks there, not afraid to put their body on the line to help out their goaltender. And with 3:07 to go here in the third period. Faceoff will be to Jack Hansen's left. Dorcas can't win the draw for the Wildcats. Shot gonna careen around the boards. Mayer has to get back, collect, he'll dump it back in. Mayer is able to hold it in, Bakken right there. Bakken forces that one through. Bakken gets a piece on that pass. Titans got a scramble. Takes a weird hop off the boards. Shot on just wide. 2:30 remain. Bakken down low. Cuts back in front. Poked that player on the ground. Play is covered up. And we'll have a stoppage with 2:25. And with the faceoff in the Tartan end, most likely we will not see them pull their goaltender here. Got to get the puck down on the other end for a bit of safety. Will be Nick Jinx on the draw. He's able to get it back. Pelkovich will send that down low. Kammerer getting that one down. Kammerer again right there. Bertelsen will chase. Finger still in net as that one goes over the boards behind the Chisago bench. Minute 58 to go here. Face off again to Hansen's left. See the top line come out for the Titans once again, and we'll see a timeout for Tartan as they look to draw something up. We see the whiteboard get drawn, the markers come out. Got to draw up a play here. Upcoming broadcast here on SEC Sports. We got boys basketball on the 31st. It's the Zephyrs and the Titans. And then on February 2nd, it'll be boys hockey, the Zephyrs and the Cadets. That'll be a barn burner, two of the top teams in the Metro East Conference. And we got girls hockey on Valentine's Day, the Section 4AA semifinals. Boys basketball's Matamidi takes on the Hastings Raiders and girls basketball on February 22nd as the White Bear Lake Bears take on Creighton Darum Hall. Head coach Cole Leach drawing something up. We see Corey Lashenko getting some words into his team. I'm sure it's keep it simple. Stay in front of pucks as you've been doing all night long. I know we don't have a blocked shot counter, but I would not be surprised if Chisago Lakes is leading that stat line here. As Titans come out of the timeout. Minute 58. Need one to tie. We'll see what they can do. Net is empty. Pelkovich will chase that one around. That one's going to go wide. It will be icing. Minute 50. And for the Titans, you got to win that faceoff draw. It all starts right there. If you can't win the draw, you're not going to be able to get possession. There you go. You win the draw. Titans wait with Reach up top. Joyce cutting it close, inside Reach, just there, gets it back down to the corner. Scrum back down low, 90 seconds. Jinx has it, he'll try to spin that one around. But Reach is right there. Pelkowitz pinning the Titan along the board. And it'll be Blum to clear that one down for icing. 75 seconds now. Chisago Lakes, they're oh so close, but it's not over just yet. But maybe an empty net at the other end. But they got to get the clear and get that on net, otherwise it will be icing. Jinx can't win the draw. Titan player tied up. Down low, this one poked out. This one not going to go for icing. Final 60 seconds. Titans lose the handle. Scrum down at center ice. Stick handle attempt. A little too much of a fancy pass there from Reach. Dug in to Joyce down low. He loses a stick. Got it like that. It's going to... I am surprised that is not a boarding penalty. as a Wildcat went head first into the board. A rip from up top, gonna get blocked by Blum down low. He's hurt. 20 seconds. Just in front, behind the net. Reach, shot, dug it! As it's Cameron top shelf! Just like that. We're all knotted at three. 13 seconds to go from Colin Kammerer. From Sean Duggan. Holy smokes, ladies and gentlemen. Don't go anywhere. It's not over. Wow. As Colin Kammerer just cannons this one. Makes his way through traffic. I don't even know if Hansen saw it. And what looked to be the bookend is just another chapter yet to be written. With 7.6 on the clock, we'll have one last face-off. Will be Nick Jinks on the draw for Chisago. Gets to the point. This one thrown on net, blocked. One last rip from Madden, blocked, and that will be the end of regulation. We will need extra time here to settle this one. The Titans score three in the third period to force overtime. As I initially thought, when Chisago went up 2-0, I thought this game would be a bit kind of, I kind of almost wrote this one off, but that does not seem to be the case. And with a bit of time here before the overtime, we'll take a look at the highlights, take a look at the goals. And the first one here, Borowski in the low slot, tips that one in. And then it was Brock Thompson to make it 2-0 for Chisago. At the end of two, then it was the Titans. Backdoor feed from Kammerer, he gets his first. And then it was Sachs, just a puck, just sitting on top of Hansen's pad, just pops it back in the net. Play wasn't dead. And then it was Nate Blum, past two defenders, go top shelf. And it wasn't the only time the puck went top shelf tonight. That's just a few moments ago. Colin Kammerer does it again, knots us at three. And in overtime, who knows what will transpire. 3-3 going into OT. It is anybody's game. It's now, I don't know. I'm not even sure who I could pick in this one. Tartans played phenomenally as of late, and the Wildcats have kind of stepped up the gas. But for the majority of the game, the Wildcats have played better. But now we're at the end of the game. So for Tartan, all of a sudden I think you have all of this momentum and you gotta roll with it, but you can't get too overzealous. You gotta calm yourself down. It's still, you're in sudden death overtime here. You can't make any more mistakes. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, to follow us here on social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube, SCCTV and SCCTV Sports. Get updates on all your favorite local teams here on the East Side and much, much more. As it'll be a single 5-on-5 overtime period. 8 minutes is regulation. If no team scores after 8 minutes, it will be declared as a tie. But if one team scores, they will get a check in the W column. And loser will get a check in the L column. Plenty on the line here. Dorcas going to work that one around a Titan defender. Dorcas down low. Still has the puck. Low slot right there for Bakken. Now going up ice is Reach. Reach lost the handle on it, collects it, knocked to the ice. No call, gets that one back to Wolf. Duggan will sling it around. Mayer will force it right back. Saga waits to space out a little bit. Bakken with room. Shot fired, chipped off the goaltender in the back of the net. Chisago lakes in overtime from the speedy Bakken. Gives the Wildcats the win. 57 seconds, all that's needed. Wow. What a heartfelt effort from the Titans. Three goals in the third. And it was not enough. And Bakken, again, just gets a burst of speed coming into the zone. Waits, releases, labeled for the top shelf, back of the net. And for Ben-Gurion, just got a piece of it. Just needed a little bit more than chipped over his glove. As that is all she wrote, as we see the handshake go through. And to me, I was thinking to myself, Bakken has had so many chances tonight to find the back of the net. It was only a matter of time. And boy, howdy, is it a big one. As the overtime game winner from the junior forward. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in here on SCC Sports. I hope you've enjoyed yourself in an absolute stellar hockey game. As for everyone in the truck, all the camera people here, and myself, Earnhardt, Mike Jaworski, thank you. And fans, we'll bid you adieu, and we'll see you in the next one.